AddForce, Velocity, Translate, Move Position. Which one is better? Hi everyone, welcome to Rehope Games. I'm Murat. In this video, we will talk about movement systems. We can move an object by changing its transform values, or we can add rigid body component and move it with physics engine. We can move an object in three different ways using Rigidbody. As you can see, there are many different movement systems. What are the features? How to use? In which case, which one should be preferred? When you watch this video until the end, you will have learned the movement systems completely. Okay, let's begin with transform.translate. As you can see, I prepared a simple scene like this. There are colliders like this on the scene. I'll add a script to the player named movement controller and open it. We also saw the difference between get axis and get axis raw. You can browse and customize the input manager if you wish in here. You can use transform.position or transform.translate. Both move the object with the same logic. But transform.translate is more useful and practical. I want the player to flip its face towards the direction it's moving. Let's do this with code. We can move the player as we want, but as you can see, the player is not affected by gravity and does not collide with other objects. If you want a smooth movement, you can use get axis. I want to show one more feature about the translate. If you choose self, the player moves relative to the local coordinate system. If you choose world, the player moves relative to the world coordinate system. Transform.translate not affected by the laws of physics. We have completed the movement with transform.translate. Next movement system, move position. We will move the player using the physics system. I will add a rigidbody2D component to the player. We should write the code related to physics system in fixed update. Let's take a look at the differences and usage areas between update and fixed update. Okay, let's move the player with move position. Change body type of the player to kinematic. Start the game. Kinematic Rigidbody is not affected by the laws of physics and does not collide with other objects. Next movement system is Velocity. Thanks to the RV.Velocity, we determine the velocity of the Rigidbody. You can use it when you want to change the speed suddenly. Can be used with kinematic and dynamic rigid body. I just want to interfere with its velocity on the x-axis. As you can see, the player is affected by gravity and collides with other objects. Please take a look at this table to better understand how objects interact with each other. The last movement system is AddForce. Before, I want to make a short announcement. The next video will be about the jumping system. After completing the basics, we will make 2D games from scratch. Please don't forget to subscribe to be notified of new videos. Let's continue. Force is applied to the object. Object moves with force. At first, the most realistic movement system, and only runs with dynamic rigid body. Back to movement controller. The object moves by gaining speed with the effect of the applied force. Let's take a look at the logic of force. Any physics lovers here? Let's get to know force mode 2D. Default force mode is force. Impulse adds an instant force impulse to the rigid body. I think when you look at the screen, you will understand the difference between impulse and force better. If the mass is increased while the force is constant, the acceleration will decrease. I hope you found the video useful. Please don't forget to subscribe and like. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.